Wow, how cool is this? On the count of three, can I get a go ponies? One, two, three. That's awesome. Before we get started today, I've got a little surprise. I have a friend here that is the director of the Wisconsin Rural School Alliance, and he's here to give a special award. So, Mr. Jeff Ivey.
Wow. Sort of get a little close to the mic and try to say how close or how far away do I need to be? That's good. First of all, former high school teacher, former principal, former superintendent, this is awesome! Well, I want to introduce myself. My name is Jeff Ivey. I have the privilege to be the executive director of an organization called WRSA, which is the Wisconsin Rural Schools Alliance, and I'm the executive director. We have over 300 schools that are rural in town in Wisconsin this time. And WRSA receives nominations for Administrator of the Year, Principal of the Year, Teacher of the Year, and a number of others. Today, it is my privilege and pleasure to recognize the Wisconsin Rural Schools Alliance Support Staff Member of the Year. This award is for an individual support staff member and WRSA member who provides outstanding service and supports students, staff, and parents at facilities, fosters cooperative relationships with colleagues, parents, and community, understands and assists the individual needs of the constituents, demonstrates a thorough knowledge of skills and expertise required to effectively perform their job duties. Can a support staff person, member would be one of the most valuable, indispensable staff members in an entire school district? Yes, it can. In Monticello, it is undoubtedly so. Got the echo on me? Working on it? There you go. The tech people. Ah, I love the tech people. Carolyn Schwartzlow. I can tell her now she has to be in the background, but that's not going to happen, Carolyn. In Monticello, it is undoubtedly so. Carolyn is a fourth generation Monticello and has been part of Monticello for school district since she was 4 years old. After graduating from Monticello and UW-Madison, Carolyn returned home and has helped lead the district for the past 9 years. Carolyn's most notable roles include school nurse, athletic director, summer school coordinator, summer recreation director, mental health team member. However, she also manages the wellness program, backpack program, service day, health fair, career fair, girls on the run, leads the district safety team. You don't do much, do you? In addition, she teaches 4th and 5th grade human growth and development and healthy habits to elementary care regularly. Carolyn also coaches volleyball in middle school, high school as needed. Yet, her favorite roles in the district are trusted friend to many and being a mom to Ian 18 and Derek 15. To manage the roles above, Carolyn has to be organized, tech savvy, and most importantly, an amazing communicator. Furthermore, without being the most trusting, honest, genuine person you'll ever meet, it wouldn't be remotely possible. Carolyn has endless energy and love for the district. Her passion is evident when dealing with students, staff, parents, and community members, and can be seen by the countless hours she spends in the district. I heard you get to put on your apartment. That was nice. Yeah. Now imagine managing these roles during a pandemic. We are very proud of the success that the district has shared over the past 30 months, and we manage educating while keeping staff and students safe. Superintendent Brockow, I said it right this time, has said, as a superintendent responsible for making decisions, there is no one I was more reliant to trust again. And I and the school district of Monticello were and are so lucky to have your leadership and knowledge. We simply could not ask for a better person to represent Monticello in so many capacities. Carolyn will impact the lives of Monticello kids. I asked like 10 times, and when I say it, my wife and I had an argument over those. Monticello kids and community members, just for being here. Carolyn is quite simply one of our district's greatest treasures and the epitome of a team player in a rural school district. I need to read the plaque, and then we can move on. Wisconsin Rural Support Staff Member of the Year presented Carolyn Schwartzlow, Monticello School District, in recognition of your dedication to provide exceptional service to the children in your rural school and community. Let's give her a huge round of applause.
Mr. Olson, our MC for the day.
I'm embarrassed, and thank you, and I'm the one that's left, and let's really do what the party is for tonight. Our volleyball team and fall athletes.
All right, ponies. So, like Ms. Carolyn said, we are here today to celebrate our fall athletes and to bring the school spirit for a big, big volleyball matchup tonight. Before we get into that, I need to second everything they said. Nurse Carolyn, as my AD for basketball, is amazing, fantastic, and deserving of every honor. Give her one more big hand, please. All right, now, ponies. I heard Mr. Bachman ask you to go ponies earlier. But if you see the sign up there, we got a theme today. What's that sign say? Let's go, ponies. So, I want to hear this from you before we introduce our fall athletes. It's going to go, let's go, ponies. Clap, clap. Let's go, ponies. Clap, clap. Let's go, ponies. Clap, clap. Let's go, ponies. So let's, first off, start off by introducing our high school football team members who are coming off a big season-ending victory last week. Members that we have, we're going to start with our freshmen, work our way up. Football players, stand up so we can see where you're at and get a little bit of recognition. We have Trenton Hassler. We have the Hitman, Tristan Pittman. We have a Trey Blaze. Jesse Huerta. Coming through in the clutch, Mason McCutcheon. Zeus Blaze. Alright, next, want to introduce our cross-country team members. Both of these teams are coming off their fourth consecutive conference championship, which is incredibly impressive. We'll start with the boys team. We have Ben Collins. Ray Valentine. Colin Blue. And a second team all-conference member, Ian Schwartzlow. And on the girls' side, we have Ellis. First team all-conference member, Molly Olson. And let's not forget our coach, Delwich. course, we still need to introduce our high school volleyball team. Our high school volleyball team, on their, they are currently on their second consecutive conference championship. Just last week, won the regional championship for the second consecutive year. And now we're going to have a final. Let's get a quick clap for all of you.
Yeah.
the other team misses the serve. You guys are going to yell, how high is the net? Too high. How high is the net?
Too high.
Over the net, over the net, over the net. We're going to do it first.
Oh.
made sandwiches. I can see it coming, Raiden.
All right. Raiden, 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 Raiden.
Use these chairs. let's have freshmen down there. Sophomores here. Juniors. And seniors. Oh, I got the hype squads. We need a member of each class to be a balloon holder. A balloon holder. Looks like maybe you got some, maybe one of you guys want to be like, oh, look at a balloon holder right here. So here's going to be the rules real quick. So when we say start, one partner will start down here on this end, right? And when we say go, partner's going to take the balloon, run down, and chest bump their partner to break the balloon, right? Partner's going to be actually standing up, going to chest bump it, break it, run back, get another balloon. Now your partner's sitting, second round, and you're going to have to pop the balloon in their lap. Last round, come back, get a third balloon, your partner's going to lay on the ground, and you have to break the balloon on their body, with your body. Like a drop, if you will. First class done, we'll be reigning champions. All right, so competing for the, let's see, freshman. We have, let's hear that for the freshmen. We've got David and Thomas. Sophomores, is it Ryder? Ryder, are you going for sophomores? All right, we have Mason and Ryder, sophomores. Juniors, we've got Ryan Tyler. And for seniors, we have Aiden and Ray. Get behind your class, pick your winning team. On your marks. Get set. You're there for a hype man grant. That's your hype, that's it. Right? Not much hype, but hey, they're freshmen. Ready, set, go! So, we have some musical entertainment for you also coming up here. So if you are participating as a musical entertainer, we're going to need you out here because there's not going to be a lot of time in between it. Because you get about 3 seconds from one act to finish before the next one's ready to go. We're going to keep this moving. So, let's have you down. Down there, no more of this. So that's even the, you know, all groups. Okay, the first group is a lot of girls. Second group is Quade's group. Third group is Peyton's group. After Peyton's group is the Spanish group. After Spanish is Becker's group. And after Becker's group is the middle school group. So just so you know, be ready to go. You're gonna hustle up front and center and do your thing. All right, we have groups ready to go. Staff groups, you're up here ready to go too. There's not a lot of time. Okay, so before they dance and sing your brains out, we have an awesome opening act today. Our opening act today is MC Crazy KJ. Dance along, everyone. Thank you. and the fiesta has been won.
Thank you.
school. So we'll help you out if you guys didn't remember. Okay, so here's elementary.
Drop off the glorious six on the doors. We can have them put it together. It'd be awesome. Well, I will see you.